Well, joining me now from Warsaw is Dominik Tarczynski. He's a member of parliament with Poland's ruling Law and Justice Party. Dominik, good to have you on the Newsmakers once more. 27 of those Supreme Court judges.
Thank you for having me.
Being forced to retire. Why are you doing this?
First of all, they're not forced to retire. This is what our act saying, that everyone who is over 65 is obliged to apply to the president for the permission to judge in the future to continue their work. So they can continue, they can apply, and most of those judges who are under new law, which is 27, most of them 16 already applied to the president, so they agreed this law is constitutional and we're gonna follow the new bill. That's clear.
They can apply. President Duda can deny their application without giving a reason. Is that fair?
Well, it's the same as it is in European tribunal. It's the same as it is in Germany when the minister appointing the chief judges. It's the same as it is around the world. And I'm happy you're mentioned about what is fair or what is not fair. To understand the need for this reform, you have to understand the history of Poland. We are keep repeating, some of these judges are the judges coming from the communist times, the ones who were judging during the martial law. These people shouldn't be the judges. That's number one. This is what are the expectations from the Polish society. This is what we promised during the campaign. So I think this is fair, to have a major democracy, not the communist judges.
Right, but if a judge committed a crime, if a judge did something wrong under the communist era or under martial law, if a judge is guilty of corruption, why not try them? Why not show the evidence and try them?
Well, that's the very good question. Me as a parliamentarian, I can lose my immunity by the Polish law. I can be put in front of the prosecutor and be sentenced and go to jail. It's different with the judges. They couldn't be put on trial because our law so far did not let us this kind of chances. So it is changed now. We do hope for justice. And I do believe that in the future, those who are stealing, who are drunk driving judges, will pay the consequences. The worst thing is that last month we had a judge who was caught on camera stealing 50 zloty, about 10 euros. And judge, his colleagues, a court says that he didn't steal anything. He was just outside of his thoughts and minds because he was busy about his work. It's just ridiculous. We have to change that.
Chief Justice Gersdorf, massive demonstrations on the streets in support of her. Do you respect those demonstrations?
No, 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 no. What do you mean massive? Can you put the number? Can you give me a number?
I've seen big pictures. I don't know. You tell me. It's relative. There's lots of support. Do you agree?
Well, that's the very, very huge problem because most of the pictures were used from the previous years. And the funny thing is that previous President Lech Wałęsa, who was there, he was saying that he's expecting 2 million. Then he says he's expecting 1 million. 2 days ago, he says that he's expecting 100,000.
Okay,
and yesterday, he says, oh, I'm really sorry. It's not even 100,000 in here.
Okay,
we're not going to change anything.
Okay,
so, so few of
our
you.
Viewers are
so,
looking at pictures. Okay, hold on for a second, Dominik.
To find what picture
okay,
is it?
Certainly. Our viewers are looking at verified pictures of demonstrations on the streets of Warsaw, right? We're looking at these pictures. Accept our petition to EC, defend
right.
the Supreme Court in Poland. Now, I'm not an expert on crowd numbers, right? But it looks big, and it looks like there is a significant amount of people
yeah.
there feeling very passionate about the Chief Justice. There we go, right? And they say, these are not my words, they say
so
it's
I
a...
Do I'm really happy that
I'm not giving you hundreds of thousands,
streets,
I'm not giving you millions,
protest,
I'm not giving... Okay,
that
and this
are,
is good.
They have a right
okay,
that no one's
good.
Shooting them as
okay.
it was in a... previous time,
but
previous
that's a low bar, right?
With
to say nobody's
bullets.
Shooting them. Let's listen to their argument
important.
For a second. Dominik.
Even if there was 100,000.
Okay, fair enough. So let's listen to their argument for a second. They're saying, isn't it a coincidence that just like the Chief Justice, many of these other judges are against the ruling party? Isn't it a coincidence that these judges are now being asked to step aside? Is that fair?
No one is asked to resign. This is the bill, the new act, which is absolutely the same as it is in many European countries. And they are not sucked. They are not losing their jobs. They can apply to continue their mission. But coming back to the numbers, even if there would be a 20,000, 50,000, 100,000, to compare 100,000 with millions which elected law and justice, which elected our government it's completely different story. And this government was elected because we promised this reform, because Poland had to suffer under the communism, and it's completely different perspective than for Germany, France, or Turkey. Right. It's completely different. We suffered a lot, yeah. And those who were the pillars of the communism are still there. I hope they will not ask for the continuation as the law allows right. them, and I hope they will go away.
Right, and what we're not asking here, we're not asking whether you have a democratic mandate or not, or whether you have the right to do this as the ruling party. You have the right to do this as the ruling party. We're asking about whether it is right and whether it's fair, constitutional, and so forth or not. The European Commission's not happy. They notified.
No one is asked to resign. This is the bill, the new act, which is absolutely the same as it is in many European countries. And they are not sucked. They are not losing their jobs. They can apply to continue their mission. But coming back to the numbers, even if there would be a 20,000, 50,000, 100,000, to compare 100,000 with millions which elected law and justice, which elected our government, it's completely different story. And this government was elected because we promised this reform, because Poland had to suffer under the communism, and it's completely different perspective than for Germany, France, or Turkey. Right. It's completely different. We suffered a lot, yeah. And those who were the pillars of the communism are still there. I hope they will not ask for the continuation as the law allows right. them, and I hope they will go away.
Right, and what we're not asking here, we're not asking whether you have a democratic mandate or not, or whether you have the right to do this as the ruling party. You have the right to do this as the ruling party. We're asking about whether it is right and whether it's fair, constitutional, and so forth or not. The European Commission's not happy. They notified you, the Polish government, that
they've begun. Well, the European Commission is not happy yeah. about any conservative yeah, government
in, a way, that's
in Europe.
True. Okay,
they are not
fair
happy
enough.
About Hungary.
Fair
they are
stab.
Not happy about Poland.
Infringement
they are not happy
proceedings.
About Italy. They are not happy about okay. Chancellor of Austria. They are not happy about Visegrad okay. Group. They are not happy about anything.
Okay,
which
so let's
is
ask about what
liberal,
they're particularly.
Leftist.
Okay,
they
so let's ask what they're not particularly democracy. Happy about with you. Infringement proceedings into this matter about the judges. Does it worry you at all that the European Commission is not happy and they're taking legal action against you?
Well, first of all, they have no right by the treaty. The treaty is very clear. The judiciary systems in the member states are the member states' thing. No one can interfere into the judiciary. That's number one. Number two, even if they're trying to start with a legal action, you know they need unity. They need all member states' votes. They will not get it ever because, as I mentioned, Hungary, Austria, the whole Visegrad group is against it. And I know that what they're scared of is the elections to the European Parliament. They know that they will lose. They know that the European Parliament will change soon, and they're trying to use their power to help their friends in Poland, leftists in Hungary, in other. It's just a politics. It's all about refugees, as they called illegal immigrants, crisis. It's because they are unhappy about our decision about it. We said no, and we're not going to change right. our mind. Angela Merkel started this madness, and she has to pay for it.
Okay, if they're all lefty liberals in Brussels and in Berlin and elsewhere, and you mentioned, as you mentioned, your country and Austria.
Most of them.
And Italy and so forth, why do you stay? Why do you even bother? Why don't you leave the European Union?
Because we believe the European Union is a value. We want to be the part of the European Union as a partners, and we want to reform European Union. And you have to remember about the fathers of the European Union who are about to become saints. They were very straight about Christian roots of Europe, about Christianity as an identity. So we cannot withdraw from this hard work of reforming and changing EU, coming back to the roots and to the fathers who started, who built it, European Union. At the moment, it's just a part of the history for the leftists. They're going to lose soon.
Dominik Tarczynski, good to talk to you as always. Thank you for joining us.